and I've been thinking about it a great deal.
Why, you're David Smith.
Jefferson's partner.
David Smith, my parents. Oh, how do you do, Pettit?
You know what I was thinking? What, Mrs. Custer? If two people wanted to go on a honeymoon, they could just take the boat to New Orleans and motor right up through the south to our home.
Oh, it's a wonderful place for two people.
That wouldn't be very good, excuse me. That wouldn't be very good for him. You remember how sick you were the time we took that night? I haven't any more shorts.
Anne kind of took care of his things around the house.
Little household things.
I'm one of the best housekeepers you ever saw. I suppose you're wondering about us. Well, it's quite simple. I've known Anne for a long time and wanted to marry her. Still do, as a matter of fact, but... Well, fortunes of war.
Oh.
I see. And let me tell you something. I owe no finer compliment than I could pay to any girl than to tell you this. When a man has been sitting across the breakfast table from the same woman for 3 solid years and still wants to marry her, well, she's quite a girl. Jefferson, I see you in private, please. Come, Mother. Excuse us, please.
Yes, certainly.
Excuse me, Mother.
We could go in here, Tom.
In here, Jefferson.
What kind of white trash is this you've taken up now? Now, Father, I know it sounded very confused. I wasn't confused at all. What's he doing with a hot water bottle on his stomach?
I'm sending sauce, the laundry.
3 years' breakfast. Well, they had a very peculiar relationship.
Well, then. Well, on our skis. Why, it's David.
What are you doing here?
Awesome. Well, don't mind soaks. You're coming inside.
Oh, he is.
What is he, Jess? He's...
Would you hold his arms?
Oh, but you...
No, no, his arms. Oh. And maybe I can look. Oh. Let me see now. Well, Anne, you hold his legs, huh? That's fine. Too heavy for you, honey?
No, no, I guess I better go first. Oh, easy, Jeff.
One step.
Yes.
All right.
Here.